Okay, this is our 30-foot water rod. It is a three-step bottom. All the graphics are 100% gel coated. Lettering is all custom painted in urethane to match each boat's design. For rub rail, we use the plastic molding with a stainless steel rub rail in the inset. This is one of the only bottoms that has a variance degree bottom. This boat has a 22 degree V and a 25 degree V from the last step and the last chime back. This allows for the boat to have a smooth entry and a fast 9-foot delta pad. On the back swim step, we have all anodized, color coordinated grab handles and ski toes. We have lights on the swim step to make sure you have a well-lit platform to step on. We have a 15 degree transom. All of our boats have through transom exhaust. The outdrive by owner's request is a Volvo DPX drive, and the gear ratio in this one is 1591. It is a dual prop with counter rotating, E4 props. It also has external steering to allow the boat to steer at high speed, so if anything gives away, you still have control. Underneath the bottom here, this is a 4-inch notch down to an 8-inch delta pad.
We've had the water rod for 3 years, and we needed it because we needed a bigger boat and we needed a faster boat.
This is my third one, and the first two I was able to sell and purchase the other one without any loss of money. Any significant loss at all, so it's been a very good experience resale-wise.
My first boat, I was actually on my way to another manufacturer to look at a boat I already had in mind, and I just happened to stop by here by accident, and I said, let me see what you got, and I was very impressed in what I saw and the quality and the craftsmanship and just the overall presence of what the boat was, and for the price, you can't beat what you got going on. So I had no choice, I bought the boat. Never made it to the second place. I was hoping to get there, but I didn't even go look at the other place. I ended up, made the final deals here, came back the next day, gave my down payment, and that was pretty much the end of the deal.
Every interior is custom designed to the customer's specs. We design and pick fabrics out and make sure we meet every customer's needs and qualifications that they want in their boat. This one has Dana hinges. The Dana hinges are a pneumatic hinge. It works faster than standard hinges or screw hinges with rams. We have storage panels inside here with lights. In the top storage bin, we have an amp from Kicker, and we have room on the shelf below it for another amp. And then below it, we have a storage compartment that's covered, and then a space for storage with a sideboard in between there. And on each side, the Group 27 batteries are set in a billet battery box. The rear bench seat is large enough for 5 large adults. Underneath our bench seat, we have storage compartments that has an inverter and a battery switch in it. The back of our cushions are covered and complete. For the people in the rear seat, we have rear footrest standard in our boats. Down here, we have floor storage for most buoys. It's carpeted inside and out, and even on the inside of the lid, is carpeted with 40-ounce carpet. You never have to worry about sticking your hand into a compartment, getting raw fiberglass or wood splinters stuck into you or anything of that nature. Into the side gunnel wall, we have the speakers and two color coordinated cup holders. Even when your cooler's in there, you still have the ability to open the cooler to its full opening lid capacity. Underneath the cooler, we have a large area for storage, front and back. Above the cooler in the gun wall is through bolted stainless steel grab handles with color coordinated bezels.
Yeah, the water rod's a better boat. It's a better boat than any boat out there. I wouldn't own anything else. It's durability seems like it's better. It's faster than most boats its size. It rides a lot better than any boat I've ever been in. It's just a better boat all the way around.
You feel safe in it. I love the water rod because it's deeper. You stand in it, and with kids, we have two young children, so with kids, it's, you know, you don't have to worry about them falling out unless they're trying to hang over the edge, which, you know, they don't do. They could barely, by climbing on the seats, get up to look over when we first got our first one. And I feel safe in it. I don't like the boats where you're sitting and you can reach out and touch the water. You know, it's too close right, to the water. Right. I feel safe in the boat. It rides nice. It's smooth. You can feel that it's sturdy, and it's still, even with it being sturdy like that, it still moves.
Yeah. The water rod's a boat. I mean, it's a boat. You know what you think about a boat. You know, what your granddad would have driven, you know, a boat. Something that's heavy yet fast.
Take a look at a water rod. You'll be impressed. They've lived up to all of my expectations. I think what says the most, when I got my second boat, I really just wanted the exact same thing as the first.
These seats are what we call our fat boy seats. They sit way up above your shoulders, and you're in here so you cannot move around and go anywhere. These are stainless steel stands with dropout booster seats. They allow you to ride offshore and stand up, and they have storage behind them for small things like purses or anything that you don't want to ever get wet. To the side in the gun wall, we have another kicker 6x9. Below it, we have a storage compartment again, well carpeted, and a light below it. In front, the kick panel, we have a space that's color coordinated, custom spray, so that you have a way of bracing yourself if you are in an offshore rough water condition. We also have a stainless steel grab rail right here on the gun wall, again, through bolted, stainless steel with color coordinated bezels, so you can grab on at any given time. As well as we have a cup holder for your sodas or whatever you prefer to drink. And we have a locking glove box that's here for you to put things inside.
Well, I regularly boat with 10 to 12 other people, and none of us has the same boat. So I have a good opportunity to see what other boats, how they ride, how they perform, their build quality. The water rod, for my third one, it speaks for itself. We take it out to the ocean, take it out to the lake. It loves rough water. Some of the other boats, well, all of the other boats, have limitations that the water rod doesn't have. I'm able to take this boat anywhere I want, in any water conditions. And that's why, one of the main reasons I bought it.
Obviously it gets rough. People don't realize, but it gets rough like the ocean out there. It gets real bad monsoon weather. When they're coming in, I'm going out. You know, I'm going out to play. That's playtime. The water rod, the water gets bad, that's playtime. The boat seems to like it the best, runs the fastest on that choppy water. The harder the water, it seems like the water rod likes it more.
I'm a pretty aggressive driver, and I like to push it to the limit. And the smaller boat, you got to back off. You know, you hit some rough water, and you just can't do it. You just beat the crap out of yourself and my wife. Scoop has always said, you know, when you get in the rough water, you want to smooth it out, speed up. And that's exactly what I wanted to hear.
over at the helm, we have a color-coordinated Dana steering wheel, Lavorsky gauges with color-coordinated bezels around the end. We have a wraparound gauge panel for all the switches. Some switches are lighted and some are rocker switches. We have the tabs indicator and we have the trim indicator. The shifter and the throttle by Lavorsky, color coordinated, and this is an upgraded item. We have the base by Kicker and 12 volt power adapter below it. And in the gun wall above the cell phone pocket, we have the cup holder. This is the Pioneer head unit that we use to power the Kicker amp and the Kicker 6 6x9s and the Kicker 2 12-inch woofers. Below it, we have the ignition key.
The general population doesn't set their standards as high as I've noticed from a water rod. And when you pull up in a water rod, people know it's a water rod, and they know who you are, and they usually remember your boat. You know, it's a stimulating feeling, if you will. It's kind of boosts your manhood a little bit when you pull up and you got the nice thump in the motor and you beach the boat and everybody's going, hey, you know, nice boat. And I say, yeah, it's a nice boat. And they, that's a water rod? Yeah, it's a water rod, you know, and everybody knows it's a water rod. That's what it is. Everybody is kind of, you know, when you have a custom car, kind of people, everybody knows a 57 Chevy, you know, it's just because of its style, you know. Well, everybody knows water rods because of their style. They're that, just that on the market.
You know, when you have the throttle down in this boat, it's very, very solid. When you're banging through wakes and waves, you come down and you get a solid feel. A lot of boats rattle and twist and creak, and you don't get that with this boat. And I've had boats since I was 16 years old. And that's, you can go out on a boat and immediately tell if it's a strong hull. And this is a very, very secure boat. The flash gets you. And you wanna go as fast as you can, you wanna look as good as you can. But of course, if you're not safe in the boat, you don't feel comfortable in the boat, you're not gonna go as fast as the boat could go.
The boat handles really well. We can make a nice tight turns for the wakeboarding. It handles at high speed. It's a nice boat.
He agreed to go with the acrylic door, sliding door, that is tinted. We got front acrylic door as well. We have a flip down piano hinge that allows the door to have double locking power. We can lock up here and we can lock down here. It folds up and goes into its own pocket. We have a microwave, a cooler underneath. So over here we have a color coordinated cup holder. We have a pocket for you to put DVD tapes, a cooler hand. We have a 20 inch flat screen TV built into the wall. Our headliner starts at the floor and it goes up and over in one piece. And it's 1 inch padding. The storage spaces in this boat is phenomenal. We have storage behind the cushions and we have covered storage underneath the cushions. You do not have to worry about cutting your hands or anything. Behind these seats here, we have mood lighting. For bright lights, we have the white lights up on the bulkheads. The panel control, we have storage for DVDs and any food supplies you want. We have the DVD player stereo with 5-inch speakers on either side of the cabin. And here, we have storage space as well as a light when you're working on it, as well as you can put things in there and lock them. On this side, we have storage lower and upper, and we have another 5-inch speaker. Also, we have running lights all the way through the boat. These here block outs for a separate cushion that will sit down in here and become a bed.
There's no kind of low-end water rod.
I like the way that you can have a nice custom sound system and a fast boat. I mean, you don't have to have like a plain gutted out boat. It's like a luxury car. In the sense of a boat, and it's fast. It's like a race car, but a Bentley at the same time.
A hot boat mentioned that it was the fastest accelerating boat, coast to coast. That's a lot to say for a performance boat manufacturer, for the big name magazine like that to go ahead and name that, a water rod to give it that title. That's a pretty powerful statement to come from Hot Boat Magazine. I mean, a lot of people reference their buying and selling off of that magazine and Powerboat as well, and they both had quite responsive write-ups on those articles. So I was impressed with them.
The way the water rod family deals with you, the way we came down with our first boat and took pictures every step of the way. And Scoopy always took the time to come out and show us and get in the boat and show us what he did and show us this and that. And it was nice. When we looked at the other boats and things, you didn't get that. You didn't get that personal feeling that they cared what you thought, this is how we do it, this is what it looks like, this is what you get.
There's no two boats that are ever same when you get a water rod. It's a one-off deal. You order what you want, you get what you want, and it's supported by excellent service. And you never if you see two water rods, they must have begged them to do it the same, because each water rod's different, and that's what's unique about them. And they all have their own special touch, and they all represent 90% of the time, at least for me, they represent what I want at that time and who I am. So.
Shots, I call audibles. Shake up the jeweler, bubbles, the rain swat sort of do. It's big ballin', baby, when I'm courtin' you. I'm talking spy bags and fly pads and rooms at the Bloomberg and rumors. You on the verge of a new merch, cause that rock on your finger's like a tumor. You can't fit your hand in your new purse. It's humorous to me, they watchin' and we just yachtin' Allen, hoppin' off the Amalfi Coast. Mafioso, oh baby, you ever seen satin?
We have storage in here, and it's carpeted on the floor. As you can see, he's got his life jackets in there. And over here, we have a center cushion that has carpeted storage space in there. And even the anchor locker is carpeted and storaged up there. Every area is covered. And then behind the seat, that's angled, we have a large fiberglass storage area. All these boats has the angle, so when you sit back in it, your arm naturally rests on the grab rail for you to have a comfortable ride, safe, and feel secure. Inside the side gunnel, two cup holders that's color coordinated as well.
Mafioso, oh baby, you ever seen satin? No, not the car, but everywhere we are. You sure to see stars, this is high level, not eye level, my bazooka.
The first thing people see when they see this boat, they just stop and stare. And then when they hear it start up, they look even more.
Everybody liked it. Everybody that sees it likes it. As I believe lots of people call, about the boat when they see it. We've taken people out on the boat that are out there. You want to see how it rides. Yeah. You know, people like it.
It gets old when they knock on our hotel door, though. You know, at 12, 1 o'clock in the morning, there's people banging on our door.
That's your boat in the parking
lot?
Hey,
I seen your boat on the parking lot. Can I go get in it? Like, now?
Quality of the boat is outstanding. The performance is top-notch, and the service is unsurpassable.
The performance factor, that you can do whatever you want with that boat, and it's shown by the professionals and magazines. It's shown by people who have driven the boats, that reviews on the boats. It's hard to find a hard review on a water rod. You know what I mean? The worst thing that I've ever seen is a tint on the windows.
Yeah, water rod gets its due out there. It really does, you know, because people come up on you could tell by looking at one boat, especially when you're parked right up next to it, at another boat. And what I really like is the fact I'm looking, I'm going, and I probably paid $30,000-$40,000 less than they did. But water rod's the only boat I'd buy.
A water rod.
That's dead serious honesty. Otherwise, I wouldn't have two. The best money I ever spent was a water rod.
Yeah,
no doubt about it.
It's tricky, I'm picky, baby, but I just spotted you doing your thing, G-string, shoestring, point of view. Hey, lend me your body, you got me in a zone. Bet a million and a half cash, I can make you very small. You don't wanna play with the cones, you wanna take the cones. I can take you on out of limits away from home. Where your girls come, I'm wildin' for show. In the middle of the club, doing a rodeo show. The whole scene's steamy, wet, dreamy. Invisible sex, clean me. Incredible sex, you need me. Your knees, me, please me, baby. Come on, baby, hand a little face.
Oh,